In this tutorial, we are going to perform JUnit testing in Java. So basically, I have this Eclipse IDE. So we are going to perform JUnit testing in Java. So in Eclipse IDE, we are going to create some JUnit tests, which are going to perform some testing procedures. So what exactly do we do in JUnit test is that we test some units, and units are basically functions in your program. So let's suppose you have a lot of functions in your program and you are getting an unexpected output of your program. It means that some function is not actually giving you the desired output. So instead of checking the whole program, what you can do is you can actually break the whole program into units, which are basically functions, and you can test them individually. So without running the program, you can actually give some values to the function as a parameters or as inputs, and you can check whether the function is giving you the desired output or not. So let's start with this. First, I'm going to quickly create a Java project. In the Java project, I'm going to name it as JUnit testing. So we will click next. Then we will go on this add project JUnit testing to build path. All right, so next we are going to click finish. Now here it will create a source folder, and we will quickly create a package here, and let's name this package as test, right? So I will quickly finish it, and in this we are going to create a class, a Java class, and let's name this class as unit testing class. All right, so we will click finish here. So here is our class. Now in this class we are going to create some functions. We are going to start with one function and we will create some more functions. And what we will do is we will not run this Java class. We are going to just run the test, and we can basically test particular functions in it. So quickly, I'm going to create a function, which is a square function. And if you give some input n to this function, it is actually going to give you the square of the number, which is n squared, something like this, right? So a very simple function. And let's suppose you replace this function with some other function. One thing will remain constant is that you are going to provide some inputs and you are expecting some outputs. All right, so let's create our first JUnit test. So here I'm going to go on my project name and I'm going to right click and go to new. And here, if you will go down, you will see JUnit test case. So quickly click here, JUnit test case. It will open up this dialog box. So let's name this as square unit, because we are actually testing the square function. So I'm naming it as square unit. All right, and here you can see it's saying new JUnit Jupyter test. Instead of this, I will recommend you to click on new JUnit 4 test. All right, so we have now done this. Now click on finish here. And it will ask you to perform the following actions. Click OK. Now you can see it creates a particular Java class here, which is squareunit.java. And inside this, we are going to actually try to test our square function. And then we will run this class. So what we can do is here in the test function. So whenever you will run this class, it will start with this test function. So what I'm doing here is I'm going to quickly create an object of our unit testing class, the class in which our function resides. And I'm going to create an object of this class, which is unit testing. Right, so now I'm going to use this object to call the square function, and I'm going to give some output, some input parameters here. So let's suppose I will give 4 here. So object dot square function, and let's give 4 as an input. So if I will give 4 as an input to this function, it's going to give us some output, right? So let's store that output in the output variable. And since it is coming from the function, I'm going to name it as output underscore f. All right, so now we're running the test, and this will call the test function, and we have stored the output, which is coming from this function square. So similarly, if you have any other function in your main class and you just want to test it, you can just create an object and call it and store the output here. Now the next task, which is an important task, is to test the output, right? So we're going to make use of assert equals function, right? So this function is basically used to perform the test. In this function, we will provide it with two input parameters. One is the expected output, which you want that this function should give. So square of 4 is 16, so I want that this function should give me 16 as the output. The second is what exactly this function is giving me, which is output f. So I'm going to pass output f here. So now you see, if you will run this square unit.java class, it will run this test function, and assert equals will test that the output which is coming from the function which was inside our class, if the output is actually equal to the output that we expect. You can see here this is 16, which is the output that I want this function to throw. So now let's run this. Just go on square unit and click on run. So let's see what will be the output. All right, so it's saying that cannot find this on project build path. Can we run if this? Okay, click on OK here and just go here, run all tests in the selected package or source folder and click on apply, then close it and then again try to run this. So now you can see here, after running this, you will be able to see it says run one on one, and you can see a green progress here. So this means that the output which is coming from this function is actually matching the output that I expect. So now let's say I expect that this function square should give me 17. 4 square, I think that it is 17. And what I'm going to do here is I'm going to test whether the function is giving 17 or not. So in that case, I will run this again. And you can see here it says failures 1, and it shows a red line here, which shows that the test was not successful because the output that is coming from the square function is not equal to what we expect. Now we exactly know how to test a function in our class. Without even running this class, you can test the function. Now I'm going to create another function so that in most of the programs we have multiple functions. So I'm going to show you how you can actually run the test for multiple functions. So I have created a function sum here, which will return me the sum of two numbers that I will give it. So now I will create a separate test for this function, which is the JUnit test case. And I'm going to name it as sumUnit because it is the sum function. Then I'm going to click on finish. And you can see it will create class sumUnit. Again, what we're going to do is we're going to follow the same method which we have done in the previous section, and instead of square function we are going to pass sum, and sum expects two input parameters, which is 4 and 5. So 4 plus 5, I want the output that will come from this program as 9. I will save it and then I will run it, and again I'm going to do this, run all tests in the selected projects, apply and close, and then run this program again. And you can see that it says that the test on the sumUnit function is now done. So if you want to test any particular specific function, you just click on the class and you run it. And after running it, you can see that it is running the test. So What will happen if you want to run all the tests? So let's suppose in this function you have 10 and maybe a lot of functions, and what you want to do is you want to run all the tests on all the functions so that you will be able to see clearly here which function is doing wrong and you can actually go out there. So for that we have a JUnit test suite. So I'm going to click other here, click other. Now here I'm just going to minimize it. So it will open the dialog box with these options. Just go on Java, scroll down and go to JUnit, and you will see JUnit test suite. So we're going to click here, we're going to click next. Now you can see here it opens a dialog box like this. Now in case of package, we're going to go on browse. So we have the tests package. I'm going to click OK here. So whenever I will click OK, you can see it will show me all the test cases. So in I'm going to select all the tests, all the unit tests that we are running, and I'm going to quickly click on the finish. So it will create a all test dot Java class, which will you can see which will run all the classes inside this class. So if I will run this, you can see here it displays runs 2 by 2. This means it is running 2 test cases and both the test cases have passed. So these are the 2 test cases which have passed. If one test case fails, what we are going to do is if you will run the all test, now you can see it will show you that these 2 tests are not there is some problem with these 2 tests, and it shows the failure, that there is a failure in your test, right? So in this way you can actually do the unit testing in Java, and it can help you a lot in finding out the errors and debugging, right? So that's all for this tutorial. Thanks for watching.